This is a model of the human skin. Its layered structure protects us so effectively, and it's an incredible organ. Now, aside from very small grazes and cuts, nearly every wound leaves some degree of scarring. In this video, we look at why. Skin is composed primarily of collagen, and a scar is also composed primarily of collagen. So the main difference is the way the proteins arrange themselves. Collagen is the most abundant protein in the human body, making up most of our skin, bones, tendons, and ligaments, which means it's very versatile, with its arrangement and density making all the difference. In normal skin, the collagen is arranged in a basket weave formation, where the fibers cross each other. In a scar, the fibers rush to heal the wound as soon as possible. Coupled with the movements around the wound, the fibers tend to line up in a single direction. It's the overly aligned collagen fibers that give that uneven skin appearance, which we observe as a scar. The main concern is usually around their appearance, but scars can also cause some serious issues. For example, after a heart attack, if the cardiac tissue scars, this can leave the heart inhibited and its ability to pump blood. There are a few things to try in order to reduce scarring in general. Trying to prevent any contraction or movement around the injury may help, as well as injection of some steroids, fillers, laser treatments, and others, but there is still a lot of research to do in this area before we can leave surgeries scar-free. Interestingly, it's not clear why scars don't occur in a normally developing fetus, for example, but suggestions tend to point to different activities of the immune cells in the womb environment, which slows that repair process and allows a proper basket weave formation to occur in nearly every occasion. There's one extra piece of information to mention before this video ends, and that's fibrosis. Fibrosis is a common disease where scar tissue progressively forms and hardens on our internal organs, such as the kidney, liver, and the lungs. This is thought to begin just like any other wound repair, although the scar continues to grow and can eventually overtake and strangle the entire organ. Fibrosis can be quite damaging and remains the leading cause of liver failure in our society, for example. Overall, when the process of connective tissue deposition goes wrong, it can be very damaging and is thought to be responsible for 40% of all deaths in developed nations. Treatment for fibrosis and connective tissue deposition defects remain a developing area of research, but a very important one in the science and physiology community.